Hello everyone, welcome. My name's Igor. I just finished my third year as a mechanical engineering student at City University of London. And today I'm making this video to go through my experience and shed a bit of light to what it's like to study at City University of London doing a mechanical engineering degree. So what I thought I would do for you guys is talk you through the three different years of the mechanical engineering degree to give you a slight insight of what it's like to study it, because you know, you can definitely feel how the degree gets more challenging year by year, but it's not always that obvious how, all right? And I think that is what's very important with this degree, is knowing how it's more difficult and being able to adjust quickly, right? And be able to, you know, manage it all on time to be able to get a successful result at the very end. So starting off with the first year, in my personal experience, I found the year quite challenging, but I think that boils down to the fact that university was a total different experience of learning for me. You know, you quickly find out that university is very independent and no one's gonna push you to do the work. So you gotta stay very motivated and have a strict plan from the very beginning to do all the work that is necessary. And you know, by that I mean, you know, attend all the lectures, make notes for the lectures, complete the questions that you're given in the lectures before the tutorial sessions, so that if you do have any queries about them, you know, you can ask the professors in the tutorials. And I followed that plan throughout the other 2 years, and I found it to be very successful. So on top of that, we also had the wind turbine challenge. Now, me personally, I'm a very hands-on learner, so any practical work I really, really enjoyed. And this was a very hands-on practical project or challenge. And so, you know, creating this and competing with the other teams was very fun and was probably the most enjoyable part of the first year. Moving on to the second year, you can definitely feel the step up in work. You know, not only does the actual content get more difficult, but the amount of work that you're given also increases, you know. But if you stick to the tip that I gave at the very beginning, where, you know, if you do all the lectures, attend all the lectures, try all the questions in the lectures, attend the tutorials, then you should be absolutely fine, you know. Even though it's a lot of work, it is doable. You know, before the lockdown happened due to COVID-19, you know, me and a bunch of my friends, we would stay in the library till late hours, but it was enjoyable, you know, because you're surrounded with people who have the same passion as you and are as driven as you. So, you know, the hours, you don't really feel them go by. You just do the work and you enjoy it. And you learn more when you're surrounded with a group of people, like I said, who are motivated and are as driven as you are. As for the practical side of things, in the second year, we had to come up with a table tennis trainer launcher. And this basically consisted of having a system which was capable of holding a certain amount of ping pong balls and then be able to aim it to shoot through certain targets placed on a ping pong table. Now, in my opinion, this was probably the most interesting and most vital the design project that we took part in during the degree, as you know, it taught me time management skills. As like I said before, the second year is packed with a lot of content, and so being able to manage your time perfectly to be able to complete this project was vital. But also it taught me, you know, team working skills. You know, you get put into a team and everyone has a role, and being able to complete that role and communicate your ideas across clearly and efficiently is very important. And so it was a very fun project. Unfortunately, we did not manage to finish it due to the lockdown restrictions of COVID-19. However, we were one of the few teams which managed to build our design and be able to test it very shortly, which was very fun. Moving on to the third and final year, in my experience, it was the most difficult year, and it's not necessarily because of the fact that you are given a lot of content, but it's more the difficulty of the content. And on top of that, you are introduced to the dissertation project, and that is a very independent thing that you will be doing, and it's a totally different experience to what you are used to from the first and second year. You know, you got to do all of the work yourself, all the research, all the calculations, all by yourself. You are given a supervisor, which does help you throughout the year. However, you know, once again, it's something that you're not very familiar with. At least I wasn't very familiar with, and so it was a totally new experience. And I did learn a lot from it. You know, time management. And just being able to do things independently and being able to research things independently, which is very, very huge, because it then helped me to study all the other modules more independently in the third year, which made it a little bit easier for me. So throughout my city experience, I joined only one society, and that was the Music Society. But it was a great one to join, as you know, you would meet people who had a passion for music, which is definitely what I have, and you could see the different talents that people had and the different instruments that people could play, and you know, you would all go and jam, and you know, this led me to form a small band with a few of my friends. It wasn't too serious. I mean, we just went and went to the studio and just jammed to some music, but it was a very nice and enjoyable experience to just cool yourself off from the studying, and just let your brain relax and not think too seriously. On top of that, I went and played futsal every Thursday after lectures. It was a lot of fun. You know, I'm a very sporty guy, so and I love football. So it was a lot of fun to just play a five-a-side futsal game every Thursday with a bunch of my friends to just once again cool the mind and let the mind relax from all the intense studying. Studying in London has been fantastic. I've lived in London all my life, and yet still I'm exploring and discovering new things which I've never done or seen before, which just goes to show that, you know, there's just endless things to do here. And with City being located in Islington, which isn't too far from like the central London, it's just amazing. You know, you can hop in the tube at Angel Station and just end up in central, and there's just so many things you can do. So it's definitely been an enjoyable experience. So before I end this video, I want to leave you guys with a few tips, and these are tips which I wish I was given before I started my mechanical engineering degree at City University of London. So the first one would definitely be to start studying from the beginning. And I know I've said this before, but you know, making sure you attend all the lectures, make sure you make notes for the lectures, and attempt all the questions before the tutorial sessions, so that you can take advantage of the fact that your lecturers are there in the tutorial sessions for them to answer the queries you have on the questions. Another tip that I would have would be to try and create a friend group which is very motivated to study together with, you know, because these people are going to be there with you for the next 3 years, and you know, if you can push them, they will push you, and you guys will succeed together. And it's just a much more enjoyable and less intense learning experience. And the final tip would be to just take it easy and not get too stressed. Make sure you're surrounded with a good group of friends who will push you through, and you can do it. Trust me, you can do it. Just try to take it easy, not get too stressed, and just enjoy the experience.